In this video, we're going head to head, research limitations versus delimitations. We'll unpack what both of these mean, how they're similar, and how they're different, so that you can write up these sections the right way. Now, if you're currently working on a dissertation, a thesis, or a research project, be sure to grab our free templates to fast track your write-up. These tried and tested templates provide a detailed roadmap to guide you through each chapter, section by section. If that sounds helpful, you can find the link in the description. All right, so let's start with the most important point of this video. Research limitations and research delimitations are not the same, but they are related to each other. I'll unpack that a little later. So if you hear someone using these two words interchangeably, be sure to direct them to this video. So what do each of these terms mean? Well, let's start with research limitations. Research limitations are, at the simplest level, the weaknesses of the study, based on the factors that are often outside of your control as the researcher. These factors could include things like time, access to funding, equipment, data, or participants. For example, if you weren't able to access a random sample of participants for your study and had to adopt a convenience sampling strategy instead, that would impact the generalizability of your findings and therefore reflect a limitation of your study. Research limitations can also emerge from the research design itself. For example, if you were undertaking a correlational study, you wouldn't be able to infer causality, since correlation doesn't mean certain causation. Similarly, if you utilized online surveys to collect data from your participants, you naturally wouldn't be able to get the same degree of rich data that you would from in-person interviews. Simply put, research limitations reflect the shortcomings of a study based on practical or theoretical constraints that the researcher faced. These shortcomings limit what you can conclude from a study, but at the same time present a foundation for future research. Importantly, all research has limitations, so there's no need to hide anything here. As long as you discuss how the limitations might affect your findings, it's all good. By the way, if you want to learn more about research limitations, check out this video, where we discuss the 5 most common limitations we see in dissertations, theses, and research projects. If you're enjoying this video so far, please help us out by hitting that like button. You can also subscribe for loads of plain language, actionable advice. Now, if you're new to research, check out our free dissertation writing course, which covers everything you need to get started on your research project. As always, links in the description. All right, now that we've unpacked the limitations, let's move on to the delimitations. Research delimitations are similar to limitations in that they also limit the study, but their focus is entirely different. Specifically, the delimitations of a study refer to the scope of the research aims and research questions. In other words, delimitations reflect the choices you, as the researcher, intentionally make in terms of what you will and won't try to achieve with your study. As we've spoken about many times before, it's important to have a tight, narrow focus for your research so that you can dive deeply into your topic, apply your energy to one specific area, and develop meaningful insights. If you have an overly broad scope or unfocused topic, your research will often pull in multiple, even opposing directions, and you'll just end up with a muddy mess of findings. So, the delimitation section is where you'll clearly state what your research aims and research questions will focus on, and, just as importantly, what they will exclude. For example, you might investigate a widespread phenomenon, but choose to focus your study on a specific age group, ethnicity, or gender. Similarly, your study may focus exclusively on one country, city, or even organization. As long as the scope is well justified, in other words, it represents a novel, valuable research topic, this is perfectly acceptable. In fact, it's essential. Remember, focus is your friend. Okay, so let's recap. Research limitations and research delimitations are related in that they both refer to limits within a study, but they are distinctly different. Limitations reflect the shortcomings of your study based on practical or theoretical constraints that you faced. Contrasted to that, delimitations reflect the choices that you made in terms of the focus and scope of your research aims and research questions. By the way, if you want to learn more about research aims and research questions, you can check out this video where we unpack those concepts in detail. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that like button to help us reach more students. For more videos like this, be sure to check out the Grad Coach channel and subscribe for plain language, actionable research advice. Also, if you're looking for one-on-one support with your dissertation, thesis, or research project, be sure to check out our private coaching service, where we hold your hand throughout the research process, step by step. You can learn more about that and book a free initial consultation at gradcoach.com.